assignment. You cannot tell God no. You are a pilgrim in the barren land today. And today I'm telling you, brethren, that God has sent us out into the world to preach the gospel, to work for the kingdom. Yes, God sent us out here to work for the kingdom of heaven. So today, I'm telling you, many of you all are leaving to see another day, to cook some food, to make love, to have a next boyfriend, to have a next girlfriend. But that is not God's promise. God tell you, I send you into the world to bring souls to the kingdom. To bring souls to the kingdom. Today I'm going to tell you that having a husband and having a wife is a gift from God. God blesses with gifts. He blesses with husband. He blesses with wife, mother and father. He blesses with children, sons and daughters. And he tells us go forth into the world and multiply. Today, as I look around, I can see that man is running after his own self and purpose of God. And today, I will tell you that man loves the flesh and hates God. Man loves the flesh and hates his own self because man is a living soul. Man is a living soul, not a living body. And one day, as we all come here, we all will die one day. But we are a living soul that will take judgment. Judgment from a most high God is real. You see, while we are in a pilgrim journey, and we are alive, God is telling us today, come and walk at your salvation with me. Because we are still alive. People who die want to come back here to repent. And you who are alive refuse to serve that you are living God with all his way. Jesus Christ is all his way. When the law of the dead God, it will be no way, anyway, again. Death is imminent. Every man, woman, boy, girl, and child must die the flesh. We must die and go into the grave. Let God come out of that. I said, I am to our parents. He said, I am from the God who came from up to the God. You will go back one day. And Adam died at the age of 907 years. Today I'm telling you, after God of Abraham, we all died after 100 or after 70. And now you see children dying. God shot his killing the youth out there. God shot is exterminating the young men and the young women. Just is on the rising. Hatred is on the rising. For what reason should you kill your brother? You don't have life to bring your mother to life when she dies. But to listen as another brother, I'm taking that brother life. I'm taking your wife's life. I'm taking your son's life. What gives you a privilege to take another man's life? But God says, well, to you, one day, when this world, when your world is finished, you will take a righteous God, the loving, the hateful, the sin, the dedicated, the adultery. To the man loves the flesh. Man loves the flesh. You see, woman loving woman. And man loving man. Love is abomination against the Lord God. Learn the worship of idols. There's so many gods in America. America has gods on the phone, gods on the TV, gods on everything. Learn to break down the Ten Commandments and fly as God. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, P. Homosexual is on the rising. The teach your children in school against the light of God. You teach your children about homosexual and lesbian. Now your children is out there killing girls, killing your mother, killing your sisters and brothers. America, where have you put your God down today?
Yeah.
America, God is calling about. He said, it's my people who are called by my name. If you call by my name, shall heaven and earth and pray and sing the prayer of God, he said, then I shall heal the land. Then God will heal America. America was one nation under one God. America was a nation that came with God. That's why America is still victorious. God is telling you, America, to take down that homosexual thing. Take down that abomination. And worship me today. I am the Lord God, he said. I am the true and living God. I am the vine that came among you. I am the Lord God. God is telling you, America, it doesn't matter how many crimes you have committed against this kingdom. He says, God, my true and living son, my only begotten son, his name is Jesus Christ. God sent him into the world to die for a time like this. When America is falling, God is sent America to God today. God is telling America, come back to Jesus. Yes, Jesus God will wash away all America's sins today. All America can never be on the horizon. Never putting their sons and daughters on pornography just to make another buck, just to make another dollar. Women is going on YouTube and TikTok and sending new videos just to make another buck. America! God is calling you back! Come back! Jesus is calling back America to God today for the lawlessness. Come back, America. Come back, the sister, to the true and living God. He owned the church today. Jesus is on the church. He said that, he said, I am on my church. And I want every wickedness that you have committed against me. I watch all your idols that you worship and deities that you worship against all of God. You say your ancestors have done that, and I destroy them with the blood. I destroy your ancestors with the blood, and I give you now a second chance. Jesus is giving you a second chance. Jesus Christ is calling the mothers and the fathers to come back home. Come out the drugs. Come out the drugs, mama. Come out of the drugs, dad. Come back home. The kingdom of heaven depends on you.
Yeah.
You know, the kingdom of heaven will establish the names and the dark against God and promoting the things of the darkness. The darkness of most of light to welcome it. And Jesus is the only light. Jesus is the lighthouse upon the mountain where many shall get in. Today he's calling you back. Come back today and repent. Jesus is giving us, Jesus is giving us salvation free through his sacrifice. Salvation is free for you who is alive. Salvation is not for those who are dead, but those who are alive. God loves the king who died, like the rich man and the poor man. The poor man was in heaven, enjoying his eternal life with God, and the rich man was down in hell. God is better, Father Abraham, to give him a second chance to come back here in this life. Many of your family died and you say he's in a better place. But did you see him go to church? Did you see him living a life of Christ? Did you see him loving our neighbors as themselves? But when he died, you say he's in a better place. But when he was alive, he was in the bar. He has a sweet smoking drug. He is a homosexual. He is a lesbian. There was no worshiping and serving a true and great and mighty God. Today he called all queen and nation to turn back to a righteous God. He called the Muslim, the Hindu, the Buddhist. We call them all, the white, the black, the yellow, we call them all men back to Jesus. Today the time is coming close, when the Son of God will soon appear. He will appear in the cloud. He will come as a thief in the day, in the night, in the noon. God is coming soon. Are you getting ready to receive Jesus? Are you getting ready to repent now? Now is the moment of salvation. Now is the moment you can say yes to Jesus Christ. He's the only hope. Whenever your life is down and you're deep down in sin, Jesus Christ wants you in your deepest, darkest hour, and he pulls you out. Jesus pulls you out of your sin. Today I'm telling you to turn away from your sin today, brothers and sisters. Jesus is calling. He's calling you. Yes, in the book of Luke 15. Jesus leaves the 99 in the church building, and he went outside and took that one that was missing. Why don't you come back today? We are calling on the pastor. We are calling on the deacon. We are calling on the layman. We are calling on the evangelist to come out in the battle field, because the battle field has many wounded soldiers. The battle field, many soldiers are dying on the battle field. We are calling the pastors and the leaders to come on the battle field. The harvest is yet, and we have no workmen out there. Come today. Young man wants to come back home to the Lord. Young woman wants to come back home to the Lord. Why don't you come back today? For there is room at the cross. Yes, there is room at the cross for you. Just remember that you cannot serve two masters at the same time. You either hate one or love the other. If a man has two women, one is his wife and one is the outside chick. Yes. He can never love his wife because he already violates the law of us. You know, being faithful to one another. He wants us to be the outside chick. So he loves the altar chief and he hurt his wife. He was God instead. God kept his God. I'll come back to me. He said, I am a God that sees your iniquity and I will forgive you. Come back to God today. Put the Lord in your head to touch your life. It is a abomination that a man is going into another man. And it's an abomination that another woman is sleeping with another woman. It is an abomination. God is telling you that. He is showing two nations.
Yeah.
Solomon and his sister, Gomorrah. Are you waiting for the hands of God to rock America? Are you waiting for the hands of God to smite America? Are you waiting for Jesus to send out his angel and destroy America? Why don't you repent today and come back to our truth and leave a God who is willing to save you, who is willing to forgive you, who is willing to take you to the upper level? Jesus and Jesus Christ the Lord can take you to an upper level. No man can forgive you of your sin. They might have hurt you or pushed you already, but a man can never forgive you of your sin but the Jesus Christ. Today, Jesus Christ is the lighthouse. He is the house that stands upon the mountains. He is the high center. Jesus Christ is the high center. He stands high and he looks down upon us and sees an abomination against him. Why don't you turn back to pray? Why don't you turn back? Why don't you come back here to God today? Come on, brother and sister. There is a real hell. Hell is real. People are dying and dying in hell as we speak. Yes, we're waiting until judgment. People are dying and dying in hell as we speak. Because the rich man was in hell. And the poor man, he was in heaven. Hell is real. Your woman will be there. Your husband will be there. When the faith in God alone. Today is your day of salvation. God giving you today as a gift to his son. Today is the day that God is telling you, repent! 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 And turn back to him. He is Lord. And only Jesus can forgive you. Why don't you say yes today to him? Because the wrath of God is revealed against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men. You have the truth. You have the truth. You know the truth. You know that homosexual is abomination. You know that murder is abomination. You know that drugs is abomination. You know stealing is abomination. You know hatred is abomination. Who has the truth? You have the truth in your heart, but you tell it and do what you want. Today God is telling us, if my people shall come to Jesus Christ. People come to Jesus Christ. When you die, they beautify you. But you my expensive coffin. A coffin that you could have paid your marriage. That cost you almost $10,000. They put you in it, and as the night comes, the people who own the funeral home, they dump it in the dust, and they take that 10,000 coffin and go to that coffin. Making you come and making you go. Making you come and making you leave. You are a loser, so brother. So many people out there try to make the body look so beautiful. and the soul is sick. Your soul is sick. Your soul is you. You are sick. There is no matter how many makeup you put on your face, how many money you have, and you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, your God and Savior, you are sick, spiritually sick. And if you die in your sickness, you shall spiritually die on the day of judgment. What are you going to do today? Are you going to say yes?
Yes.
Are you going to say yes? Yes. Yes. Thank you, Lord, for sending these messengers, your servants, so that I can reject my lifestyle. I can get up in my past and change my purpose. I'm talking to you, Almighty God, who loved me with all my sins. Are you willing to say yes this afternoon? Are you willing to say yes to the mighty God who shifts the heavens and earth and moves the seas and all the land and find you and call you his child? Are you willing to come back home to Jesus? Your man and your demon, a woman can give you joy for 5 minutes, a man can give you passion for 5 minutes, but after 5 minutes, you're wondering what is happening to your life. You're wondering, am I making the right choice? You're wondering, if I die tonight, will he take another man, or will he take another woman?